This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Federal Reserve System, also known as the Federal Reserve or simply the Fed, is the central banking system of the United States. It was created on December 23, 1913, with the enactment of the Federal Reserve Act in response to a series of financial panics, particularly the Panic of 1907, that showed the need for central control of the monetary system if crises are to be avoided over the years. Events such as the Great Depression in the 1930s and the Great Recession during the 2000s led to the expansion of the roles and responsibilities of the Federal Reserve System. The U.S. Congress established three key objectives for monetary policy in the Federal Reserve Act: maximizing employment, stabilizing prices, and moderating long-term interest rates. The first two objectives are sometimes referred to as the Federal Reserve's dual mandate. Its duties have expanded over the years, and as of 2009 also include supervising and regulating banks, maintaining the stability of the financial system, and providing financial services to depository institutions, the U.S. government, and foreign official institutions. The Fed conducts research into the economy and releases numerous publications, such as the Beige Book. The Federal Reserve System structure is composed of the Presidentially Appointed Board of Governors or Federal Reserve Board FRB, partially Presidentially Appointed Federal Open Market Committee FOMC, 12 regional Federal Reserve banks located in major cities throughout the nation, numerous privately owned U.S. member banks, and various advisory councils. The federal government sets the salaries of the board's seven governors. Nationally chartered commercial banks are required to hold stock in the Federal Reserve Bank of their region, which entitles them to elect some of their board members. The FOMC sets monetary policy and consists of all seven members of the Board of Governors and the 12 regional bank presidents, though only five bank presidents vote at any given time: the president of the New York Fed and four others who rotate through one-year terms. Thus, the Federal Reserve System has both private and public components to serve the interests of the public and private banks. The structure is considered unique among central banks. It is also unusual in that the United States Department of the Treasury, an entity outside of the central bank, prints the currency used. The Federal Reserve System considers itself an independent central bank because its monetary policy decisions do not have to be approved by the president or anyone else in the executive or legislative branches of government. It does not receive funding appropriated by the Congress, and the terms of the members of the Board of Governors span multiple presidential and congressional terms. The U.S. government receives all the system's annual profits, after a statutory dividend of 6% on member banks' capital investment is paid, and an account surplus is maintained. In 2015, the Federal Reserve made a profit of $1,002 billion and transferred $977 billion to the U.S. Treasury. Contents 1. Purpose 11. Addressing the problem of bank panics. 111. Check clearing system. 112. Lender of last resort. 1121. Fluctuations. 12. Central bank. 121. Federal funds. 13. Bank regulation. 131. Government regulation and supervision. 1311. Regulatory and oversight responsibilities. 14. National payments system. 2. Structure. 21. Board of Governors. 211. List of members of the Board of Governors. 212. Nominations, confirmations and resignations. 22. Federal Open Market Committee. 23. Federal Advisory Council. 24. Federal Reserve Banks. 241. Legal status of regional Federal Reserve Banks. 25. Member Banks. 26. Accountability. 3. Monetary Policy. 31. Interbank Lending. 32. Tools. 321. Federal Funds Rate and Open Market Operations. 3211. Repurchase Agreements. 322. Discount Rate. 323. Reserve Requirements. 324. New Facilities. 3241. Term Auction Facility. 3,242 Term Securities Lending Facility. 3,243 Primary Dealer Credit Facility. 3,244 Interest on Reserves. 3,245 Term Deposit Facility. 3246 Asset-backed commercial paper money market, mutual fund liquidity facility. 3247 Commercial paper funding facility. 325 Quantitative policy. 4 History. 41 Central banking in the United States. 1791-1913 411 First Central Bank, 1791 and Second Central Bank, 1816-412 Creation of Third Central Bank, 1907-1913 412 1931 Federal Reserve Act, 1913 42 Federal Reserve Era, 1913 Present 5 Measurement of Economic Variables 51 Net Worth of Households and Non-Profit Organizations 52 Money Supply 53 Personal Consumption Expenditures Price Index 531 Inflation and the Economy 54 Unemployment Rate 6 Budget 7 Net Worth 71 Balance Sheet 8 Criticism 81 Conspiracy Theories 9 See also 10 References 11 Bibliography 111 Recent 112 Historical 12 External links Purpose The Eccles Building in Washington, D.C., which serves as the Federal Reserve System's headquarters The primary motivation for creating the Federal Reserve System was to address banking panics Other purposes are stated in the Federal Reserve Act, such as to furnish an elastic currency, to afford means of rediscounting commercial paper, to establish a more effective supervision of banking in the United States, and for other purposes. Before the founding of the Federal Reserve System, the United States underwent several financial crises. A particularly severe crisis in 1907 led Congress to enact the Federal Reserve Act in 1913. Today, the Federal Reserve System has responsibilities in addition to ensuring the stability of the financial system. Current functions of the Federal Reserve System include to address the problem of banking panics, to serve as the central bank for the United States, to strike a balance between private interests of banks and the centralized responsibility of government to supervise and regulate banking institutions, to protect the credit rights of consumers, to manage the nation's money supply through monetary policy, to achieve the sometimes conflicting goals of maximum employment, stable prices, including prevention of either inflation or deflation, moderate long-term interest rates, to maintain the stability of the financial system and contain systemic risk in financial markets. To provide financial services to depository institutions, the U.S. government, and foreign official institutions, including playing a major role in operating the nation's payment system, to facilitate the exchange of payments among regions, to respond to local liquidity needs, to strengthen U.S. standing in the world economy, addressing the problem of bank panics. Further information, bank run and fractional reserve banking. Banking institutions in the United States are required to hold reserves, amounts of currency and deposits in other banks, equal to only a fraction of the amount of the bank's deposit liabilities owed to customers. This practice is called fractional reserve banking. As a result, banks usually invest the majority of the funds received from depositors on rare occasions. Too many of the bank's customers will withdraw their savings and the bank will need help from another institution to continue operating. This is called a bank run. Bank runs can lead to a multitude of social and economic problems. The Federal Reserve System was designed as an attempt to prevent or minimize the occurrence of bank runs, and possibly act as a lender of last resort when a bank run does occur. Many economists, following Milton Friedman, believe that the Federal Reserve inappropriately refused to lend money to small banks during the bank runs of 1929. Check clearing system. Because some banks refused to clear checks from certain others during times of economic uncertainty, a check clearing system was created in the Federal Reserve System. It is briefly described in the Federal Reserve System, purposes and functions as follows. By creating the Federal Reserve System, Congress intended to eliminate the severe financial crises that had periodically swept the nation, especially the sort of financial panic that occurred in 1907 during that episode. Payments were disrupted throughout the country because many banks and clearinghouses refused to clear checks drawn on certain other banks, a practice that contributed to the failure of otherwise solvent banks to address these problems. Congress gave the Federal Reserve System the authority to establish a nationwide check clearing system. The system, then, was to provide not only an elastic currency, that is, a currency that would expand or shrink in amount as economic conditions warranted, but also an efficient and equitable check collection system. Lender of last resort. In the United States, the Federal Reserve serves as the lender of last resort to those institutions that cannot obtain credit elsewhere and the collapse of which would have serious implications for the economy. It took over this role from the private sector clearing houses, which operated during the free banking era, whether public or private. The availability of liquidity was intended to prevent bank runs fluctuations through its discount window and credit operations. Reserve banks provide liquidity to banks to meet short-term needs stemming from seasonal fluctuations in deposits or unexpected withdrawals. Longer-term liquidity may also be provided in exceptional circumstances. The rate the Fed charges banks for these loans is called the discount rate, officially the primary credit rate. By making these loans, the Fed serves as a buffer against unexpected day-to-day fluctuations in reserve demand and supply. supply. This contributes to the effective functioning of the banking system, alleviates pressure in the reserves market, and reduces the extent of unexpected movements in the interest rates. For example, on September 16, 2008, the Federal Reserve Board authorized an $85 billion loan to stave off the bankruptcy of international insurance giant American International Group AIG. Central Bank. Further information: Central Bank obverse of a Federal Reserve $1 note issued in 2009. In its role as the Central Bank of the United States, the Fed serves as a banker's bank, and as the government's bank as the banker's bank, it helps to assure the safety and efficiency of the payments system. As the government's bank or fiscal agent, the Fed processes a variety of financial transactions involving trillions of dollars, just as an individual might keep an account at a bank. The U.S. Treasury keeps a checking account with the Federal Reserve, through which incoming federal tax deposits and outgoing government payments are handled. As part of this service relationship, the Fed sells and redeems U.S. government securities such as savings bonds and treasury bills, notes and bonds. It also issues the nation's coin and paper currency. The U.S. Treasury, through its Bureau of the Mint and Bureau of Engraving and Printing, actually produces the nation's cash supply and, in effect, sells the paper currency to the Federal Reserve banks at manufacturing cost, and the coins at face value. The Federal Reserve banks then distribute it to other financial institutions in various ways. During the fiscal year 2013, the Bureau of Engraving and Printing delivered 66 billion notes at an average cost of 50 cents per note. Federal Funds. Main article: Federal Funds. Federal funds are the reserve balances, also called Federal Reserve deposits, that private banks keep at their local Federal Reserve Bank. These balances are the namesake reserves of the Federal Reserve System. The purpose of keeping funds at a Federal Reserve Bank is to have a mechanism for private banks to lend funds to one another. This market for funds plays an important role in the Federal Reserve System, as it is what inspired the name of the system, and it is what is used as the basis for monetary policy. Monetary policy is put into effect partly by influencing how much interest the private banks charge each other for the lending of these funds. Federal Reserve accounts contain Federal Reserve credit, which can be converted into Federal Reserve notes. Private banks maintain their bank reserves in Federal Reserve accounts. Bank regulation. The Federal Reserve regulates private banks. The system was designed out of a compromise between the competing philosophies of privatization and government regulation. In 2006, Donald L. Cohn, vice chairman of the Board of Governors, summarized the history of this compromise. Agrarian and progressive interests, led by William Jennings Bryan, favored a central bank under public, rather than banker, control, but the vast majority of the nation's bankers, concerned about government intervention in the banking business, opposed a central bank structure directed by political appointees. The legislation that Congress ultimately adopted in 1913 reflected a hard-fought battle to balance these two competing views and created the hybrid public-private, centralized-decentralized structure that we have today. The balance between private interests and government can also be seen in the structure of the system. Private banks elect members of the Board of Directors at their regional Federal Reserve Bank, while the members of the Board of Governors are selected by the President of the United States and confirmed by the Senate. Private banks give input to the government officials about their economic situation, and government officials use this input in Federal Reserve policy decisions. Government regulation and supervision. Ben Bernanke, lower right, former chairman of the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. At a House Financial Services Committee hearing on February 10, 2009, members of the board frequently testify before congressional committees such as this one. The Senate equivalent of the House Financial Services Committee is the Senate Committee on Banking, Housing, and Urban Affairs. The Federal Banking Agency Audit Act, enacted in 1978 as Public Law 95-320 and 31 U.S.C. Section 714, establish that the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System and the Federal Reserve Banks may be audited by the Government Accountability Office, GAO. The GAO has authority to audit check processing, currency storage and shipments, and some regulatory and bank examination functions. However, there are restrictions to what the GAO may audit under the Federal Banking Agency Audit Act, 31 U.S.C. Section 714b. Audits of the Federal Reserve Board and Federal Reserve Banks do not include one transactions for or with a foreign Central bank or government or non-private international financing organization, 2 deliberations, decisions, or actions on monetary policy matters, 3 transactions made under the direction of the Federal Open Market Committee, or 4 a part of a discussion or communication among or between members of the Board of Governors and officers and employees of the Federal Reserve System related to items 1, 2, or 3 C Federal Reserve System audits, restrictions on GAO's access GAO, TGGD 9444, Statement of Charles A. Boscher. The Board of Governors in the Federal Reserve System has a number of supervisory and regulatory responsibilities in the U.S. banking system, but not complete responsibility. A general description of the types of regulation and supervision involved in the U.S. banking system is given by the Federal Reserve. The Board also plays a major role in the supervision and regulation of the U.S. banking system. It has supervisory responsibilities for state-chartered banks that are members of the Federal Reserve System, bank holding companies that control banks, the foreign activities of member banks, the U.S. activities of foreign banks, and EDGE Act and agreement corporations, limited-purpose institutions that engage in a foreign banking business. The Board and, under delegated authority, the Federal Reserve Banks, supervise approximately 900 state member banks and 5,000 bank holding companies. Other federal agencies also serve as the primary federal supervisors of commercial banks. The Office of the Comptroller of the Currency supervises national banks, and the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation supervises state banks that are not members of the Federal Reserve System. Some regulations issued by the Board apply to the entire banking industry, whereas others apply only to member banks, that is, state banks that have chosen to join the Federal Reserve System and national banks, which by law must be members of the system. The Board also issues regulations to carry out major federal laws governing consumer credit protection, such as the Truth in Lending, Equal Credit Opportunity, and Home Mortgage Disclosure Acts. Many of these consumer protection regulations apply to various lenders outside the banking industry as well as to banks. Members of the Board of Governors are in continual contact with other policy makers in government. They frequently testify before congressional committees on the economy, monetary policy, banking supervision and regulation, consumer credit protection, financial markets, and other matters. The Board has regular contact with members of the President's Council of Economic Advisers and other key economic officials. The chair also meets from time to time with the President of the United States and has regular meetings with the Secretary of the Treasury. The chair has formal responsibilities in the international arena as well as regulatory and oversight responsibilities. The Board of Directors of each Federal Reserve Bank District also has regulatory and supervisory responsibilities. If the Board of Directors of a district bank has judged that a member bank is performing or behaving poorly, it will report this to the Board of Governors. This policy is described in United States Code. Each Federal Reserve Bank shall keep itself informed of the general character and amount of the loans and investments of its member banks with a view to ascertaining whether undue use is being made of bank credit for the speculative carrying of or trading in securities, real estate, or commodities, or for any other purpose inconsistent with the maintenance of sound credit conditions, and, in determining whether to grant or refuse advances, rediscounts, or other credit accommodations, the Federal Reserve Bank shall give consideration to such information. The chairman of the Federal Reserve Bank shall report to the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System any such undue use of bank credit by any member bank, together with his recommendation whenever, in the judgment of the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System, any member bank is making such undue use of bank credit. The Board may, in its discretion, after reasonable notice and an opportunity for a hearing, suspend such bank from the use of the credit facilities of the Federal Reserve System and may terminate such suspension or may renew it from time to time. National payment system. The Federal Reserve plays an important role in the U.S. payment system. The 12 Federal Reserve Banks provide banking services to depository institutions and to the federal government. For depository institutions, they maintain accounts and provide various payment services, including collecting checks, electronically transferring funds, and distributing and receiving currency and coin. For the federal government, the Reserve Banks act as fiscal agents, paying Treasury checks, processing electronic payments, and issuing, transferring, and redeeming U.S. government government securities in the Depository Institutions Deregulation and Monetary Control Act of 1980, Congress reaffirmed that the Federal Reserve should promote an efficient nationwide payment system. The Act subjects all depository institutions, not just member commercial banks, to reserve requirements and grants them equal access to reserve bank payment services. It also encourages competition between the reserve banks and private sector providers of payment services by requiring the reserve banks to charge fees for certain payment services listed in the Act and to recover the costs of providing these services. Over the long run, the Federal Reserve plays a role in the nation's retail and wholesale payment systems by providing financial services to depository institutions. Retail payments are generally for relatively small dollar amounts and often involve a depository institution's retail clients, individuals, and smaller businesses. The Reserve Bank's retail services include distributing currency and coin, collecting checks, and electronically transferring funds through the automated clearinghouse system. By contrast, wholesale payments are generally for large dollar amounts and often involve a depository institution's large corporate customers or counterparties, including other financial institutions. The Reserve Bank's wholesale services include electronically transferring funds through the Fedwire Funds Service and transferring securities issued by the U.S. government, its agencies, and certain other entities through the Fedwire Securities Service. Because of the large amounts of funds that move through the reserve banks every day, the system has policies and procedures to limit the risk to the reserve banks from a depository institution's failure to make or settle its payments. Structure. Main article: Structure of the Federal Reserve System. Organization of the Federal Reserve System. The Federal Reserve System has a unique structure that is both public and private, and is described as independent within the government rather than independent of government. The system does not require public funding, and derives its authority and purpose from the Federal Reserve Act, which was passed by Congress in 1913 and is subject to congressional modification or repeal. The four main components of the Federal Reserve System are 1. The Board of Governors, 2. The Federal Open Market Committee, 3. The 12 regional Federal Reserve banks, and 4. The member banks throughout the country. Board of Governors. Main article: Federal Reserve Board of Governors. The 7-member Board of Governors is a federal agency. It is charged with the overseeing of the 12 district reserve banks and setting national monetary policy. It also supervises and regulates the U.S. banking system in general. Governors are appointed by the President of the United States and confirmed by the Senate for staggered 14-year terms. One term begins every 2 years, on February 1st of even-numbered years, and members serving a full term cannot be renominated for a second term. Upon the expiration of their terms of office, members of the board shall continue to serve until their successors are appointed and have qualified. The law provides for the removal of a member of the board by the president for cause. The board is required to make an annual report of operations to the Speaker of the U.S. House of Representatives. The chair and vice chair of the Board of Governors are appointed by the president from among the sitting governors. They both serve a 4-year term and they can be renominated as many times as the president chooses, until their terms on the Board of Governors expire. List of members of the Board of Governors. The current members of the Board of Governors are as follows. Governor entered office term expires Janet Yellen, chair February 3, 2014 as chair October 4, 2010 as governor February 3, 2018 as chair January 31, 2024 as governor Stanley Fisher, vice chair May 28, 2014 June 16, 2014 as vice chair January 31, 2020 as governor June 12, 2018 as vice chair Daniel Tarullo January 28, 2009 January 31, 2022 Jerome H. Powell May 25, 2012 June 16, 2014 New term January 31, 2028 Lael Brainard confirmed June 12, 2014 January 31, 2026 Vacant nominations, confirmations and resignations. In late December 2011, President Barack Obama nominated Jeremy C. Stein, a Harvard University finance professor and a Democrat, and Jerome H. Powell, formerly of Dylan Reed, Bankers Trust and the Carlyle Group and a Republican. Both candidates also have Treasury Department experience in the Obama and George H.W. Bush administrations, respectively. Obama administration officials regrouped to identify Fed candidates after Peter Diamond, a Nobel Prize-winning economist, withdrew his nomination to the board in June in the face of Republican opposition. Richard Clarida, a potential nominee who was a Treasury official under George W. Bush, pulled out of consideration in August, one account of the December nominations noted the two other Obama nominees in 2011, Yellen and Raskin, were confirmed in September. One of the vacancies was created in 2011 with the resignation of Kevin Warsh, who took office in 2006 to fill the unexpired term ending January 31, 2018, and resigned his position effective March 31, 2011. In March 2012, U.S. Senator David Vitter R.L.A. said he would oppose Obama's Stein and Powell nominations, dampening near-term hopes for approval. However, Senate leaders reached a deal, paving the way for affirmative votes on the two nominees in May 2012 and bringing the board to full strength for the first time since 2006 with Duke service after term end later. On January 6, 2014, the United States Senate confirmed Yellen's nomination to be chair of the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. She is slated to be the first woman to hold the position and will become chair on February 1, 2014. Subsequently, President Obama nominated Stanley Fischer to replace Yellen as the vice chair in April 2014. Stein announced he was leaving to return to Harvard May 28 with 4 years remaining on his term at the time of the announcement. The FOMC already is down 3 members as it awaits the Senate confirmation of Fischer and Lael Brainard, and as Obama has yet to name a replacement for Duke Powell is still serving as he awaits his confirmation for a second term. Alan R. Landon, former president and CEO of the Bank of Hawaii, was nominated in early 2015. By President Obama to the board in July 2015, President Obama nominated University of Michigan economist Catherine M. Dominguez to fill the second vacancy on the board. The Senate had not yet acted on Landon's confirmation by the time of the second nomination. Federal Open Market Committee. Main article, Federal Open Market Committee. The Federal Open Market Committee FOMC consists of 12 members, 7 from the Board of Governors and 5 of the regional Federal Reserve Bank presidents. The FOMC oversees and sets policy on open market operations, the principal tool of national monetary policy. These operations affect the amount of Federal Reserve balances available to depository institutions, thereby influencing overall monetary and credit conditions. The FOMC also directs operations undertaken by the Federal Reserve in foreign exchange markets. The FOMC must reach consensus on all decisions. The president of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York is a permanent member of the FOMC. The presidents of the other banks rotate membership at 2- and 3-year intervals. All regional reserve bank presidents contribute to the committee's assessment of the economy and of policy options, but only the 5 presidents who are then members of the FOMC vote on policy decisions. The FOMC determines its own internal organization and, by tradition, elects the chair of the Board of Governors as its chair and the president of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York as its vice chair. Formal meetings typically are held 8 times each year in Washington, D.C. Non-voting Reserve Bank presidents also participate in committee deliberations and discussion. The FOMC generally meets 8 times a year in telephone consultations and other meetings are held when needed. Federal Advisory Council. Main article, Federal Advisory Council. The Federal Advisory Council, composed of 12 representatives of the banking industry, advises the board on all matters within its jurisdiction. Federal Reserve Bank's main article, Federal Reserve Bank map of the 12 Federal Reserve districts, with the 12 Federal Reserve banks marked as black squares, and all branches within each district 24 total marked as red circles. The Washington, D.C. headquarters is marked with a star also. A 25th branch in Buffalo, New York had been closed in 2008. The 12 Reserve Bank's buildings in 1936. There are 12 Federal Reserve banks and they are located in Boston, New York, Philadelphia, Cleveland, Richmond, Atlanta, Chicago, St. Louis, Minneapolis, Kansas City, Dallas, and San Francisco. Each reserve bank is responsible for member banks located in its district the size of. Each district was set based upon the population distribution of the United States. When the Federal Reserve Act was passed, each regional bank has a president, who is the chief executive officer of their bank. Each regional reserve bank's president is nominated by their bank's board of directors, but the nomination is contingent upon approval by the Board of Governors. Presidents serve 5-year terms and may be reappointed. Each regional bank's board consists of 9 members. Members are broken down into 3 classes, A, B, and C. There are 3 board members in each class. class of members are chosen by the regional bank's shareholders, and are intended to represent member banks' interests. Member banks are divided into three categories, large, medium, and small. Each category elects one of the three class A board members. Class B board members are also nominated by the region's member banks, but Class B board members are supposed to represent the interests of the public. Lastly, Class C board members are appointed by the Board of Governors, and are also intended to represent the interests of the public. A member bank is a private institution and owns stock in its regional Federal Reserve Bank. All nationally chartered banks hold stock in one of the Federal Reserve Bank's. State chartered banks may choose to be members and hold stock in their regional Federal Reserve Bank. Upon meeting certain standards, about 38% of U.S. banks are members of their regional Federal Reserve Bank. The amount of stock a member bank must own is equal to 3% of its combined capital and surplus. However, holding stock in a Federal Reserve Bank is not like owning stock in a publicly traded company. These stocks cannot be sold or traded, and member banks do not control the Federal Reserve Bank as a result of owning this stock. The charter and organization of each Federal Reserve Bank is established by law and cannot be altered by the member banks. Member banks do, however, elect 6 of the 9 members of the Federal Reserve Bank's boards of directors from the profits of the regional bank of which it is a member. A member bank receives a dividend equal to 6% of their purchased stock. The remainder of the regional Federal Reserve Bank's profits is given over to the United States Treasury Department. In 2015, the Federal Reserve Banks made a profit of $1,002 billion and distributed $25 billion in dividends to member banks, as well as returning $977 billion to the U.S. Treasury. Legal status of regional Federal Reserve Banks. The Federal Reserve Banks have an intermediate legal status, with some features of private corporations and some features of public federal agencies. The United States has an interest in the Federal Reserve Banks as tax-exempt federally created instrumentalities whose profits belong to the federal government, but this interest is not proprietary. In Lewis v. United States, the United States Court of Appeals for the Ninth Circuit stated that the Reserve Banks are not federal instrumentalities for purposes of the FTCA, but are independent, privately owned and locally controlled corporations. The opinion went on to say, however, that the Reserve Banks have properly been held to be federal instrumentalities for some purposes. Another relevant decision is Scott v. Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City, in which the distinction is made between Federal Reserve Banks, which are federally created instrumentalities, and the Board of Governors, which is a federal agency. Regarding the structural relationship between the 12 Federal Reserve Banks and the various commercial member banks, political science professor Michael D. Reagan has written that the ownership of the Reserve Banks by the commercial banks is symbolic. They do not exercise the proprietary control associated with the concept of ownership nor share, beyond the statutory dividend, in Reserve Bank profits. Bank ownership and election at the base are therefore devoid of substantive significance. Despite the superficial appearance of private bank control that the formal arrangement creates, plaque marking a bank as a member. Member banks, according to the website for the Federal Reserve Bank of Richmond, more than one-third of U.S. commercial banks are members of the Federal Reserve System. National banks must be members. State chartered banks may join by meeting certain requirements. Accountability. The GAO and an outside auditor regularly audit the Board of Governors, the Federal Reserve Banks, and individual member banks. Audits do not cover most of the Fed's monetary policy actions or decisions, including discount window lending, direct loans to financial institutions, open market operations, and any other transactions made under the direction of the Federal Open Market Committee, dealings with foreign governments and other central banks. Various statutory changes, including the Federal Reserve Transparency Act, have been proposed to broaden the scope of the audits. As of August 27, 2012, the Federal Reserve Board has been publishing unaudited financial reports for the Federal Reserve Banks every quarter. This is an expansion of prior financial reporting practices. Greater transparency is offered with more frequent disclosure and more detail. November 7, 2008, Bloomberg LP News brought a lawsuit against the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System to force the board to reveal the identities of firms for which it has provided guarantees during the late 2000s financial crisis. Bloomberg LP won at the trial court, and the Fed's appeals were rejected at both the United States Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit and the U.S. Supreme Court. The data was released on March 31, 2011. Monetary policy. Further information: Monetary policy of the United States. The term monetary policy refers to the actions undertaken by a central bank, such as the Federal Reserve, to influence the availability and cost of money and credit to help promote national economic goals. What happens to money and credit affects interest rates, the cost of credit, and the performance of an economy. The Federal Reserve Act of 1913 gave the Federal Reserve authority to set monetary policy in the United States. Interbank lending. The Federal Reserve sets monetary policy by influencing the federal funds rate, which is the rate of interbank lending of excess reserves. The rate that banks charge each other for these loans is determined in the interbank market, and the Federal Reserve influences this rate through the three tools of monetary policy described in the tools section below. The federal funds rate is a short-term interest rate that the FOMC focuses on, which affects the longer-term interest rates throughout the economy. The Federal Reserve summarized its monetary policy in 2005. The Federal Reserve implements U.S. monetary policy by affecting conditions in the market for balances that depository institutions hold at the Federal Reserve Banks, by conducting open market operations, imposing reserve requirements, permitting depository institutions to hold contractual clearing balances, and extending credit through its discount window facility. The Federal Reserve exercises considerable control over the demand for and supply of Federal Reserve balances and the federal funds rate. Through its control of the federal funds rate, the Federal Reserve is able to foster financial and monetary conditions consistent with its monetary policy objectives. Effects on the quantity of reserves that banks use to make loans influence the economy. Policy actions that add reserves to the banking system encourage lending at lower interest rates, thus stimulating growth in money, credit, and the economy. Policy actions that absorb reserves work in the opposite direction. The Fed's task is to supply enough reserves to support an adequate amount of money and credit, avoiding the excesses that result in inflation and the shortages that stifle economic growth. Tools. There are three main tools of monetary policy that the Federal Reserve uses to influence the amount of reserves in private banks. Tool description: open market operations, purchases and sales of U.S. Treasury and federal agency securities. The Federal Reserve's principal tool for implementing monetary policy. The Federal Reserve's objective for open market operations has varied over the years. During the 1980s, the focus gradually shifted toward attaining a specified level of the federal funds rate, the rate that banks charge each other for overnight loans of federal funds, which are the reserves held by banks at the Fed, a process that was largely complete by the end of the decade. Discount rate, the interest rate charged to commercial banks and other depository institutions on loans they receive from their regional Federal Reserve Bank's lending facility. The discount window reserve requirements, the amount of funds that a depository institution must hold in reserve against specified deposit liabilities. Federal funds rate and open market operations. Further information: open market operations, money creation, and federal funds rate. The effective federal funds rate charted over more than 50 years. The Federal Reserve System implements monetary policy largely by targeting the federal funds rate. This is the interest rate that banks charge each other for overnight loans of federal funds, which are the reserves held by banks at the Fed. This rate is actually determined by the market and is not explicitly mandated by the Fed. The Fed therefore tries to align the effective federal funds rate with the targeted rate by adding or subtracting from the money supply. Through open market operations, the Federal Reserve System usually adjusts the federal funds rate target by 0.25% or 0.50% at a time. Open market operations allow the Federal Reserve to increase or decrease the amount of money in the banking system as necessary to balance the Federal Reserve's dual mandates. Open market operations are done through the sale and purchase of United States Treasury security, sometimes called Treasury bills, or more informally T-bills or Treasuries. The Federal Reserve buys Treasury bills from its primary dealers. The purchase of these securities affects the federal funds rate, because primary dealers have accounts at depository institutions. The Federal Reserve Education website describes open market operations as follows. Open market operations involve the buying and selling of U.S. government securities, federal agency, and mortgage-backed. The term open market means that the Fed doesn't decide on its own which securities dealers it will do business with on a particular day. Rather, the choice emerges from an open market in which the various securities dealers that the Fed does business with, the primary dealers, compete on the basis of price. Open market operations are flexible and thus the most frequently used tool of monetary policy. Open market operations are the primary tool used to regulate the supply of bank reserves. This tool consists of Federal Reserve purchases and sales of financial instruments, usually securities issued by the U.S. Treasury, federal agencies, and government-sponsored enterprises. Open market operations are carried out by the Domestic Trading Desk of the Federal Reserve Bank of New York under direction from the FOMC. The transactions are undertaken with primary dealers. The Fed's goal in trading the securities is to affect the federal funds rate, the rate at which banks borrow reserves from each other. When the Fed wants to increase reserves, it buys securities and pays for them by making a deposit to the account maintained at the Fed by the primary dealer's bank. When the Fed wants to reduce reserves, it sells securities and collects from those accounts most days. The Fed does not want to increase or decrease reserves permanently, so it usually engages in transactions reversed within a day or two. That means that a reserve injection today could be withdrawn tomorrow morning, only to be renewed at some level several hours later. These short-term transactions are called repurchase agreements, repos. The dealer sells the Fed a security and agrees to buy it back at a later date. Repurchase agreements. Further information: repurchase agreement to smooth temporary or cyclical changes in the money supply. The desk engages in repurchase agreements, repos, with its primary dealers. Repos are essentially secured, short-term lending by the Fed on the day of the transaction. The Fed deposits money in a primary dealer's reserve account, and receives the promised securities as collateral when the transaction matures. The process unwinds. The Fed returns the collateral and charges the primary dealer's reserve account for the principal and accrued interest. The term of the repo, the time between settlement and maturity, can vary from one day, called an overnight repo, to 65 days. Discount rate. Further information: discount window. The Federal Reserve System also directly sets the discount rate, which is the interest rate for discount window lending, overnight loans that member banks borrow directly from the Fed. This rate is generally set at a rate close to 100 basis points above the target federal funds rate. The idea is to encourage banks to seek alternative funding before using the discount rate option. The equivalent operation by the European Central Bank is referred to as the marginal lending facility. Both the discount rate and the federal funds rate influence the prime rate, which is usually about 3% higher than the federal funds rate. Reserve requirements. Another instrument of monetary policy adjustment employed by the Federal Reserve System is the fractional reserve requirement, also known as the required reserve ratio. The required reserve ratio sets the balance that the Federal Reserve System requires a depository institution to hold in the Federal Reserve banks, which depository institutions trade in. The federal funds market discussed above. The required reserve ratio is set by the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve System. The reserve requirements have changed over time, and some history of these changes is published by the Federal Reserve. Reserve requirements in the U.S. Federal Reserve System. Liability type requirement. Percentage of liabilities. Effective date. Net transaction accounts. $0 to $115 million. 0 December 29, 2011. More than $115 million to $71 million. 3 December 29, 2011. More than $71 million. 10 December 29, 2011. Nonpersonal time deposits. 0 December 27, 1990. Eurocurrency liabilities. 0 December 27, 1990. As a response to the financial crisis of 2008, the Federal Reserve now makes interest payments on depository institutions required an excess reserve balances. The payment of interest on excess reserves gives the central bank greater opportunity to address credit market conditions while maintaining the federal funds rate close to the target rate set by the FOMC. New facilities in order to address problems related to the subprime mortgage crisis and United States housing bubble. Several new tools have been created. The first new tool, called the Term Auction Facility, was added on December 12, 2007. It was first announced as a temporary tool, but there have been suggestions that this new tool may remain in place for a prolonged period of time. Creation of the second new tool, called the Term Securities Lending Facility, was announced on March 11, 2008. The main difference between these two facilities is that the Term Auction Facility is used to inject cash into the banking system, whereas the Term Securities Lending Facility is used to inject treasury securities into the banking system. Creation of the third tool, called the Primary Dealer Credit Facility PDCF, was announced on March 16, 2008. The PDCF was a fundamental change in Federal Reserve policy because now the Fed is able to lend directly to primary dealers, which was previously against Fed policy. The differences between these three new facilities is described prescribed by the Federal Reserve. The term auction facility program offers term funding to depository institutions via a biweekly auction. For fixed amounts of credit, the term securities lending facility will be an auction for a fixed amount of lending of Treasury general collateral in exchange for OMO-eligible and AAA-rated private label residential mortgage-backed securities. The primary dealer credit facility now allows eligible primary dealers to borrow at the existing discount rate for up to 120 days. Some measures taken by the Federal Reserve to address this mortgage crisis have not been used since the Great Depression. The Federal Reserve gives a brief summary of these new facilities. As the economy has slowed in the last 9 months and credit markets have become unstable, the Federal Reserve has taken a number of steps to help address the situation. These steps have included the use of traditional monetary policy tools at the macroeconomic level as well as measures at the level of specific markets to provide additional liquidity. The Federal Reserve's response has continued to evolve since pressure on credit markets began to surface last summer, but all these measures derive from the Fed's traditional open market operations and discount window tools by extending the term of transactions, the type of collateral, or eligible borrowers. A fourth facility, the term deposit facility, was announced December 9, 2009, and approved April 30, 2010, with an effective date of June 4, 2010. The term deposit facility allows reserve banks to offer term deposits to institutions that are eligible to receive earnings on their balances at reserve banks. Term deposits are intended to facilitate the implementation of monetary policy by providing a tool by which the Federal Reserve can manage the aggregate quantity of reserve balances held by depository institutions. Funds placed in term deposits are removed from the accounts of participating institutions for the life of the term deposit and thus drain reserve balances from the banking system. Term auction facility. Further information. Term auction facility. The term auction facility is a program in which the Federal Reserve auctions term funds to depository institutions. The creation of this facility was announced by the Federal Reserve on December 12, 2007, and was done in conjunction with the Bank of Canada, the Bank of England, the European Central Bank, and the Swiss National Bank to address elevated pressures in short-term funding markets. The reason it was created is that banks were not lending funds to one another and banks in need of funds were refusing to go to the discount window. Banks were not lending money to each other because there was a fear that the loans would not be paid back. Banks refused to go to the discount window because it is usually associated with the stigma of bank failure. Under the term auction facility, the identity of the banks in need of funds is protected in order to avoid the stigma of bank failure. Foreign exchange swap lines with the European Central Bank and Swiss National Bank were opened so the banks in Europe could have access to US dollars. Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke briefly described this facility to the US House of Representatives on January 17, 2008. The Federal Reserve recently unveiled a term auction facility, or TAF, through which pre-specified amounts of discount window credit can be auctioned to eligible borrowers. The goal of the TAF is to reduce the incentive for banks to hoard cash and increase their willingness to provide credit to households and firm staff. Auctions will continue as long as necessary to address elevated pressures in short-term funding markets, and we will continue to work closely and cooperatively with other central banks to address market strains that could hamper the achievement of our broader economic objectives.